Let the king of my heart be the mountain where I run, the fountain I drink from. Oh, he is my song. Let the king of my heart be the shadow where I hide, the ransom for my life. Oh, he is my song. You are good. The king of my heart be the wind inside my sails, the anchor in the waves. Oh, he is my song. Let the king of my heart be the fire inside my veins, the echo of my days. Oh, he is my song. 'Cause you are.
Go! spirits out, rushing wind, fire of God, fall within. Holy Ghost, breathe on us, we pray. As we repent, turn from sin, revival embers smoldering. Breath of God, fan us into flame. We need a fresh wind, the fragrance of heaven. Pour your spirit out, pour your spirit out.
BC family, and welcome to the last week of February. And just like that, we're already 2 months into 2021. So before we start our praise and worship, may I just ask you guys to join me in a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we are so thankful for everything you have provided to us this year so far, and in the previous year. I know with COVID-19, things have changed a lot for a lot of people, but despite all those changes, we are still grateful and we still lift up your name, Lord. It's in times like these that we really see the power of your strength, the power of your name, O Lord. And Heavenly Father, as we just continue with this worship, with these songs and with the message, we just ask that you lay your hands upon the songs, lay your hands upon the message, your speaker, Lord, and just upon this whole service, Lord. We dedicate this to you, and we just lift everything up to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Hi. want to greet you all in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ and welcome again to our worship celebration. And this Sunday, this is the continuation of our series that it is all about Jesus. A couple of Sundays, we studied Jesus is our example. And this Sunday, Jesus, our ransom. Jesus, our ransom. If you have your Bible with you, in 1 Timothy chapter 2, verses 5 and 6, I will be reading a New International Version, NIV. It says in here, "For there is one God and one mediator between God and mankind, the man Christ Jesus, who gave himself as a ransom for all people. This has now been witnessed to at the proper time." May God's blessing to the reading of His Word. Let's come to the Lord in prayer. Our Father in heaven, we thank you again for this Sunday that we will be able to study your Word. Thank you for the past week. Thank you again for this new brand week, O Lord, that we will be able to celebrate, to worship you, and to adore you. Indeed, O Lord, we are so thankful to you for your daily protection and provision to our lives and even to our family. At this very moment, O Lord, we humble ourselves to you, asking for your special blessing. May your word will minister to each one of us today. So, Father God, I pray every home right now, I ask for your special blessing. And for those who will listen to this message, Father God, may your Holy Spirit will speak. Because, O God, this is your word. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. Jesus, our ransom. If we will look at the central message of the gospel, is the idea of ransom. Because the Hebrew word of ransom is kopher. And as the basic meaning means of covering, then it means a redemption price, a ransom that sets free, or word satisfaction. Ransom also is closely related in thought to the concept of purchase. Ransom is purchase, buy, redeem. And the Greek term means to release on receipt of a ransom, to liberate by payment of a ransom, to redeem and deliver from the penalty of sin. So when this word is found with a prefix, meaning in the place of, instead of, for the benefit of, because there is a strong emphasis placed on the idea of substitution. Someone pays the ransom price in the place of others and with a great benefit for others. To free us from our life of sin and damnation, a ransom had to be paid. And the only payment would suffice was the life of Jesus, the Son of God. So this topic or doctrine about Jesus, our ransom, is so important topic where all the believer must understand so much because this is all about Jesus. I want to share to you a story. When I was in elementary grade back in the Philippines, I had a cousin, his age around 6 or 7 years old, and I'm around 12. And one day he was abducted and the kidnappers was asking for 1,000,000 pesos. To be honest, we were all scared that we don't know if he will still come back alive. And even my uncle, my auntie, my cousin, all the family, many people prayed for that incident. By the help of our God the Father, and also the cops and other government intelligence, the operation was successful. He was freed, and the kidnappers were caught and placed behind the bars. And praise God, that experience that I've been witness about the ransom, my cousin who has been kidnapped, I know that feeling. I don't know about you. But today our text tells us Apostle Paul is not insisting or something to be held as belief. But he is telling us something he has found the man and God, the Lord Jesus Christ, to be his consciousness of him. Because no one ever mediated between God the Father and man as Christ did. Our Lord Jesus Christ is remarkable, for the heavenly and the earthly meet in him with no difficulty. There is no defect in Jesus' character, no neglect of the minor things of life, no imperfection in human side because of his divine side. He is human, but he is also God. He was a man intensely spiritual, yet full of everything human. This meeting and blending is unique. Christ is unique in what he mediates, in what he brings down and present to us. Because his vision of God the Father, which he gave to us, is unique. Because a mediator to God of our humanity, in him we are brought near to the Father. Christ is the one and only mediator. If we will go back in the Garden of Eden, man and God was totally separated because of Adam and Eve. And Eve sin, that totally divided, totally been divided and disconnected, and someone need to be a mediator, and this is the Lord Jesus Christ. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. And he is the propitiation for our sins. The first thing that we can learn, that Jesus, our ransom, a ransom given as a gift of love. You can see that it is a gift of love. That ransom is a gift of love. When this pandemic was started last year, around March, several times, we receive, several occasions, we receive a food delivery on our door. And we praise God for this gift of love from our brethren. And greatly appreciated. And that's why we need to exercise. Because a lot of food delivery. So you can also testify in your life the gift of love of your family, your loved ones, our friends, even in the Christian circle. During this pandemic and even other occasions that you receive, you've been given a gift of love by other people. And I thank God for the gift of love for church members who keep calling to other members, encouraging them. And thank you for your continuous prayer to our church ministry. And even your financial support to the church. Even though we are not seeing each other physically, but we are connected spiritually And is the reason why we can still support our missionaries. And is the reason why we can still help other people who are in need. And even the operation of the church because of the gift of love of our brothers and sisters. Most of us are familiar with what has been called the golden text of the Bible. I'm sure you know the golden text of the Bible. We will find it in John chapter 3 verse 16. It says, "For God so loved the world that He gave His one and only Son, that whoever believes in Him shall not perish but have eternal life." In verse 17 it says, "For God did not send His Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through Him." That is a gift of love of God the Father through the Lord Jesus Christ. For God so loved the world. What kind of Father offer us His own Son as a sacrifice? He is the one who knows that only by giving up His Son will the world have a chance to be saved. That is so-called salvation. That's the meaning of salvation. Once the person put their faith in Jesus Christ, receiving this gift of love of God the Father, this person will have a personal relationship to our Lord Jesus Christ. A personal relationship to our God the Father. God loved us so much that He gave His only Son. While it is hard for us to understand this ramification of this truth, one thing is very clear: the motivation was clearly love for humankind. The love, the motivation of humankind. Even though we walk away from God, He went to most extreme measure to bring us back for Himself. The result of God's loving act was the opportunity for eternal life. And He said that all we need to do is place our trust, belief in His Son. How many of our loved ones, how many of our friends who need salvation? God give us the gift of love. That's the ransom. We can also experience it if you haven't accepted Jesus Christ. And you can maybe also the instrument to share this gift of love to those who don't have Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior. What the person need is to humble before God. Recognize that he is a sinner. Confess before the Lord. And open his heart to Jesus as a Lord and Savior. Ransom. A ransom given us a gift of love. Also, number two, a ransom given as a payment for our sin. As a payment for our sin. Whenever someone is kidnapped, there is a demand for payment. So when the payment is made, the kidnapper promises to set the person free. Jesus was the payment that had been made for us to be released from the bondage of our sin held us in. Because we are still in the bondage of sin. Not until the Lord Jesus Christ paid for us, paid for it, and then we received Him. Until that payment was made, we could not be set free. More than 2,000 years ago, Jesus Christ did for us the payment of our sin, His life, His precious blood. That's why salvation is not cheap. Salvation is so expensive because this is the life. This is the life of the Lord Jesus Christ and God the Father's only Son. in Galatians chapter 1, verses 1, verses 3 and 4. Galatians chapter 1, 3 and 4, it says in here, "Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, who gave himself for our sins to rescue us from the present evil age, according to the will of our God and Father." And also in Titus chapter 2, verse 14, "Who gave himself for us to redeem us from all wickedness and to purify for himself a people that his very own, eager to do what is good." You will see this very powerful text or message that God, the Lord Jesus Christ himself, redeemed us from all our wickedness. He paid everything. He paid everything. Neither a very single sin was not paid off. It was paid on the Mount of Calvary. And look at the list. The list of things Jesus payment for himself gained for us. List of things Jesus payment of himself to gain for us. Deliverance from our sins. Deliverance from the evil age. It means this generation, this time, this world. Deliverance from lawlessness. A newfound purity. An earnest desire to do good works for the kingdom. The moment we accepted Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, we were delivered from all of this. And we have desire to do good works for the kingdom, not for our salvation. This is the fruit of our faith in Jesus Christ, that we are saved, that we are doing good works. And Apostle Paul, instructing the young Timothy in public prayer. If you will study this text in 1 Timothy chapter 2, if you will start reading on verse 1 up to verse 12, you can find in here how Apostle Paul instructing Timothy in public prayer that supplication, intercession be made for all mankind, in all classes of men, including kings and even in authority. And Paul write this good and acceptable to God, who would have all men to be saved unto the knowledge of the truth. There is one God and one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus, who gave himself for a ransom for all, to be testified in due time. Christ gave himself for all those given him by the Father. Rich and poor, male and female, Jew and Gentile, a high and low estates, and all are under the universal bondage. The only way to be saved is to be freed from sin and death, from curse and all fear, by the ransom price that Christ has done alone can bring. If he has made us you free, then you are free indeed, because Jesus paid it all. Thank God that Jesus was willing to pay the price to set us free. But there's more. In number 3, a ransom given us our substitute. As our substitute. A ransom given as a gift of love. A ransom as a payment for our sin. A ransom given as our substitute. Jesus not only paid the price for our redemption with his own life, he also substituted his life for our own. What took place at the cross has been referred us. The divine exchange. His righteousness in exchange for our sins. His righteousness in exchange for our sins. You know what the word substitute is always used if you are playing sports. Basketball is my favorite sport since childhood. Even I played at very young age, as early as 4 o'clock in the morning. We are always go somewhere just to play basketball, even without eating, because we wanted to play. That's how I much love basketball. During basketball game, if you are playing excitedly and enthusiastically, of course you know that you are playing very good, and then your teammate or your coach will call your name, Lino, substitute. Whoa, I'm feeling so bad because I know I still have some energy to play, but when I hear about substitute, someone will come in to play for me. For our sake, in 2 Corinthians 5:21, he says, "For our sake, Jesus made him to be sin, who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God." Wow. For our sake, he made him to be sin, who knew no sin, so that in him we might become his righteousness. It was not just Jesus gave his life. He also took upon himself all the sins of humankind, sins past, present, and future. He had weight of all sins that have ever or will ever be committed upon his shoulder. So when he died on the cross, he received the punishment for sin that each of us deserved. Although Jesus did not sin, he bore our sins on Calvary in Mount Golgotha. I like what John Stott wrote about his comment about in here. John Stott, a well-known theologian, he says, "The concept of substitution lies at the heart of both sin and salvation. For the essence of sin is man substituting himself for God, while the essence of salvation is God substituting himself for man." Indeed, Jesus' act of substitution was done on behalf of every man, woman, or child in the world. But only those who accept him as Lord receive the benefit of what he has done for them on their behalf. Jesus already substituted. If the person put their faith in Jesus Christ. In my illustration earlier, if I'm playing basketball and someone wants to substitute with me to play for me, that person will play, will get my time. And then like what Jesus did for us, he done on our behalf. In Matthew chapter 20, verse 28, the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 20, verse 28, it says in here, "Even as the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life," what says here? "As a ransom for many." It says few? No, for many, for all, for everyone. He gave himself. But the only problem if people will receive him as their Savior and Lord. But the ransom was already paid. And also the Gospel of John chapter 6 verse 51. I like this verse too. In John chapter 6 verse 51, it says, "I am the living bread that came down from heaven. If anyone eats of this bread, he will live forever. And the bread that I will give for the life of the world is my flesh. It means his life on the Mount of Calvary, he given for us a full sacrifice of our life, of his life, I mean, for us. I can speak for anyone else, but I cannot think of a better preposition than in this one. Exchanging my sin, my spiritual death, and my distorted way of living for Jesus' promise for life, purity, and eternity with God in my future, does it get any better than that? No. God gave everything as a substitute. His love for us, his payment for our sin, and he is our substitute. And look at number 4. That Jesus, our ransom, a ransom, that ransom given us as a remembrance. As a remembrance. A daily infographic website offers the following list called the world's most expensive meals. I just want to mention just few. This daily, this website offers. In Pijimek Kejigo restaurant in Tokyo, you can get a bowl of ramen for $110. Wow, a bowl of ramen. In Capital Don in Sacramento, California, served the Ultra Dog, the world's most famous expensive hot dog. It costs $145.99. You just go to Costco, just only $1.99 including the drinks. $145 US. In Westin Hotel in New York City offers a white truffle bagel that sells about $1,000 US. Just one bagel. Truffle bagel. And also 1,000 New York City also boasts the Golden Opulent Sunday, which include rare cocoa beans harvested off the coast of Venezuela. 1,000. And then 2,000 slices. 2,000 a slice. In Britain, the Wagyu meat pie. I don't know how, you know, just the slice of that pizza. Because there's like a mushroom, a Kobe beef. And also in Italy, Chef Viola's Louis pizza loaded with lobster, caviar, 8 different types of cheese, and seasoned with hand-picked pink Australian river salt sells for $12,000. And that's why I'm looking forward in the next 2 weeks or few weeks when our emergency lockdown is over. I want to go to Pomi Soup, $8.99, Canadian. A ransom is given as remembrance. But you know what? Seriously, there is a meal that is of much greater value than any of these that I mentioned. It is the meal where we remember the ransom, the price that Jesus paid for us on Calvary. It is what we call the Lord's Supper. Or communion. It was instituted by Jesus himself, called remembrance. In Luke chapter 22, verse 19 to 20, and he took the bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, and gave it to them, saying, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And likewise the cup after they had eaten, saying, this cup that is poured out for you, is the new covenant in my blood. Luke chapter 22:19-20. Jesus never wanted us to forget the great price that would be paid on our behalf, the ransom. So Jesus memorialized it in this wonderful way. Every time we partake of the bread and the juice, we are proclaiming our allegiance to the one who paid it all, so we could be with him forever. When we have our communion, when we participate in our communion, we are not taking this lightly, but rather seriously, because of the ransom of the Lord Jesus Christ has done for us. The final word for this message: I am so glad that Jesus loved us enough to give himself as our ransom. He paid a price that we could never pay. Never. And he paid it for people who did nothing to deserve it. I am one of it. In fact, he did it for people who do not deserve it at all. Even with all our sin and disobedience, Jesus loved us so much, and he was willing to pay the ultimate price. But my beloved in the Lord, friends, now our work or responsibility is to share the message of Jesus' ransom to everyone who has yet to accept his gift of eternal life. It has been freely given to us. Now it is up to us, so freely give it to others. Are you ready to start doing that today? To share the ransom, the gift of eternal life to other people. The only way some people will ever know is if you and I are willing to offer this message of redemption with them. I am ready. How about you? Are you ready to share the gift of eternal life to other people? God did it for us. Jesus, our ransom, did it for us. May this message will give us the clear understanding and meaning that Jesus, our ransom, and it is all about Jesus. Shall we pray? Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for your holy word. Thank you, Father God, for helping us and guiding us to understand what ransom Jesus did for us. What is this all about? Father God, I pray that you will bless this into our heart. Continue, O Lord, to help us to digest and to think about what Jesus done for us. His ransom and our life truly is all about Jesus. Father God, thank you for this word. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen and amen. Thank you so much and God bless.
Find rest. nations rise and thunders roar. I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are King over the flood. I will be still, knowing you are God. Find rest, my soul. Rise and thunders roar. I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are King over the flood. I will be still, know you are God. When the oceans rise and thunders roar, I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are King over the flood. I will be still, knowing you are God. I will be still, knowing you are God.
Let us give God the glory for today's worship. Let's come to the Lord in prayer and let us give thanks to God. Father Almighty, we thank you for your word today. I pray that you will continue to empower your people to tell the gospel story, to recount your wondrous deeds which shine light on your glorious and holy character. Lord Jesus Christ, empower your people to announce the good news that you have brought to earth the life of heaven, that you have sacrificed yourself for sinners, that you have been raised from the dead and exalted as our Lord over all creation. Holy Spirit, empower us to live in light of the gospel, declaring its truth with our words and embodying this truth through our action. Father God, give us love for you and love for other people and for one another. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Thank you so much again for joining in our worship service. Please stay tuned. After this, you will receive a Zoom invitation. We will have, for those, we would like to invite all the members to join us and everyone to join us for this fellowship. You will receive a Zoom through our group messenger. God bless you and thank you so much. Amen and amen.